the way, my name is Deb Redd. I teach in the 4th, 5th, and 6th grade classroom. In the 4th, 5th, and 6th grade classroom, they would then use these same symbols and learn about subjects, predicates, and the parts of the sentences. So where there's a big red circle there, there's also a red circle here. This work is called sentence analysis. I'm going to start with a very simple sentence. The simplest sentence that you can have. Dogs run. Can you identify the action word, the verb, the sentence? It is run. Who is it or what is it that runs? Dogs run. On the back of the arrow, it has the word subject. On the other side, it has the question, who is it, what is it that runs? So the student has a word predicate and the subject. After much practice with simple sentences, then we can move on to a more challenging sentence. So let's introduce direct object. Mother stirs the soup. And the action in this word is
stirs.
Stirs. Thank you. The predicate is stirs. Who is it or what is it that stirs the soup? Mother stirs the soup. This is the new part. What does she stir? The soup. So the student will learn that we have the subject, the predicate, and the direct object where the action is being performed. After much practice with this, we can introduce other words. Indirect object. Again, you start with the predicate or the action word, and in this sentence, the action is gives. The predicate is gives. Who is it that gives? Sue gives. And now it's very important that we pay careful attention to the next question. What does she give? Sue gives an apple. And then our last question, to whom? She gives her apple to Jan. So now the student has learned the predicate, the subject, the direct object, and the indirect object. This is direct preparation for diagramming sentences. It's laid out the same way you would diagram sentences. Appeals to students who love math because they get to analyze the language, and it helps with learning how to punctuate sentences. goes through adverbial extensions, predicate nouns, and they'll, at the end, I have some sixth graders who've challenged themselves to write a sentence that uses the entire box. And the sentence